Hey, Jim. We've had a few questions from customers about chasing this filter press with water at the end of a filtering session. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I hear that question now and again as well. It's a good question, and it's not something I've had a lot of experience with. You know, when I'm done, when I'm getting to the end of my filtering session, I typically just dry stroke the pump. But yeah, when I break it down, there's typically a decent amount of syrup, especially if I didn't take enough care in making sure the plates are full of DE. Generally, when you have the plates full of DE, when you use a sufficient amount of DE, that displaces anything that could be in the press. But even then, I get a little bit of syrup that leaks out when I'm breaking down to clean it. So someone that does have a lot of experience is Jimmy. And I know he's bottling tonight at his mom and dad's house at their sugar bush. So maybe we'll head over there and see for ourselves.
Yeah, maybe we can see how they do it.
Yeah.
All right, let's head over there.
Sounds good.
We're just finishing up our batch. People will ask, I have syrup in my line. What do I do to finish that? And I've done this several times and tested. And I know if I do two additional strokes on my hand pump press, I'm gonna have still pure syrup moving into the bottler.
With water.
Yep, with water. With water, I'm chasing the press with two pumps, and I know that is enough, that's still pure syrup. The third pump I have, I actually usually still save and make it like a consumption jar that I use right away. But I do know that density may have changed at that point, in measuring it. And I can say that by taking that last pump and a little bit of that syrup and putting it back into my Murphy cup to know, hey, where am I at a density? And when I've done this in the past and I get to that third pump, then I know my density is off. But I still may just consume that little bit right away and use it up. I've got a little bit of hot water here. I'm gonna just go ahead and know that I'm good for two pumps, and then I'm gonna catch what's left into what I call a refrigerator jar that we're gonna keep open and not seal and use right away. I'm gonna stop there, and then I'm gonna take this out, and I'm gonna disconnect off my bottler, and I'm then gonna put this into a small bowl or container and still save what's left in that last stroke.
Figure then that's probably a little bit under density.
Yeah, so I'm figuring what's in the tray here might be a little bit under, and that I know it may not be perfectly syrup, but it may be still good and still great to consume right away.
Yeah, if nothing else, you can put it back in the evaporator.
Yep, and exactly.
So it's not going to waste.
I could put it in the evaporator, I could put it back in the finisher or in a few places to just save. You know, remember, people ask me, how much does your hand pump move? And it's close to a pint per stroke if you're getting a full stroke and it's fully, populated. So.
I just thought that during the event that they're filtering while they're running an evaporator, they may as well just keep on pumping water through that thing and take advantage of the sugar that's in there
and re-evaporate it.
And put it in the evaporator. Yeah. It's still sweeter than the sap they're boiling.
As long until this looks pretty much clear.
Yeah, I mean, to put that in the evaporator, that's the sweetest stuff you got.
Now it's starting to get pretty light. Now it's getting pretty light.
Yeah.
And now I'm probably good. What was that? Maybe a gallon of water in there?
This one was good.
If you'd like help making your filtering and bottling more efficient, check out more tutorials like this on smokylakemaple.com or call us at 920-202-4500. This is what it boils down to. Have a great day.